After World War II, almost everyone was afraid nuclear weapons were the tools that would bring civilization to an end. As with every new powerful technology, its applications can be a double-edged sword. Since the invention of fire, people have had the choice to use it to cook our food and keep us warm and safe from our predators, or use it to burn villages. In contrast to previous technologies, nuclear weapons have only one application: destruction. So every rational person is concerned about their existence. But what if there was another technology that could be seemingly all good and benign? A technology that could solve all our problems? Could that be the ultimate Trojan horse? For most of our evolutionary history, the prime survival strategy of Homo sapiens has been the way of the hunter and gatherer. Civilization only began with the invention of agriculture. For the first time in history, we started to harvest technology by automating tasks that would ensure our survival. Since then, automation has never stopped growing, and with it, civilization started to blossom all around the globe. Today, the world's economy depends on automation, and it's growing with an unprecedented rate every day. Automation is fueled by our desire for better and cheaper smartphones, computers, faster internet, better transportation, infrastructure, healthcare, security, education. Essentially, everything we want and more is propagated by intelligent systems, and intelligence is the most valuable resource we have. Or is it? In 1997, IBM's Deep Blue chess machine defeated world chess champion Garry Kasparov. This event was one of the first signs that once artificial intelligence starts to conquer ground, it won't give an inch. Now chess is completely dominated by AI engines like Google's AlphaZero. When it was first built, it didn't know anything about chess other than the rules, and in only 4 hours, it mastered the game and defeated the best chess engine, Stockfish 8. AI also became superhuman in Atari games. At first, it started by observing and learning the rules. Then it taught itself how to play and mastered different Atari games at astonishing speed. Many critics were cynical about the achievements of artificial intelligence in chess and video games and argued that these are simple tasks and an AI could never compete with humans to something more complex, like poker, where human intuition is key for strategy in an imperfect information game. In 2017, poker AI Liberatus individually defeated some of the best human poker players at an exceptionally high win rate. The Air Force invested $400 billion in the new F-35 jet fighter for their pilots, and a $500 AI designed by graduate students beat the best human pilots and the Air Force's top tactical experts. AI also beat the best human radiologists in detecting lung cancer. Its deep learning algorithms were trained to detect lung tumors by using more than 42,000 patient CT scans to predict the risk of lung cancer. $1.3 million people die in road crashes each year. On average, that's 3,287 deaths a day. An additional 20 to 50 million people are injured or disabled. This horrible statistic could be a thing of the past, once AI conquers our roads with autonomous vehicles. Our 21st century global economy is highly dependent on AI. Most of the trades in stock exchanges are initiated by artificial intelligence, so AI is already here to stay. It's everywhere in our everyday lives. It will soon engulf and dominate every field ever created by humans. The only possible way for the inevitable progression of AI to stop is if we destroy ourselves. Otherwise, we will continue to improve our machines, and one day we will go beyond artificial intelligence and stand in the presence of an AGI, or Artificial General Intelligence. For humankind's sake, we hope its values will be aligned with ours. But that's for another video. Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing, ringing the bell, and enabling notifications to never miss videos like this.